1997?
Yes.
Here and there at the same time?
Yes.
Any other countries you were top of?
There was 27 countries at one time.
Well, at one time, number one?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Pretty much, yeah.
That was the first, yeah, when the first album came out.
Which is kind of ridiculous.
I think it was when the first, that first single came out, I think it was that a record? Was that the first time that happened?
I think that was a record.
First time in the UK and the States, number one.
I want to see a bit of Umbop, because where did you go? Did you go after it into a kind of waiting room with Bebop on one side and Umbop on the other? And
you just, what are you talking about?
Where have you been? The second album was 2000. What happened since then?
Well, as we spent a long time in the studio, actually. We demoed a lot of music, and it really just, I think, in the end, it really just took a good amount of time for us to really
put together
the right album, the album that we felt was the right one. And once we got that record that we felt was the right one, we were ready to kind of go out with this acoustic tour that we've been doing and things like that.
How do you describe the new one? Why this is little bits of it. Is it much more rocky?
Well, it's a combination of a couple of things, I think. It's both elements of more kind of intimate and acoustic kind of things, but it also, I think, in many ways, it has more rock elements to it than previous
records.
Also
producing most of it ourselves. I mean, we've always been, you know, the creative control on everything we've done, but we really
took it to
the next level with the production and with also collaborations like with Greg Alexander. We did some writing with him and with Carol King and with just all kinds of different collaborations we'd never done before. And I think it just was, you know, taken to the next level. Yes.
Is it fair to say when you produce this yourself, you fell out with the label?
No, not so much. We just made a creative decision.
We felt that.
Oh, about the label. Well,
with this label.
But was there pressure to do Mbop too?
You know, we made a record and we just ended up deciding to go with what.
Oh yeah, we just started our own label, which is what you guys are leaning towards. Yeah, we just started our own record company. We finished the album and the label, you know, wanted us to be
continue
on their company. We said, you know, guys, we really want to do something different with this. I mean, that was really.
It's kind of this odd. It was this odd kind of convergence of kind of positive departing, shall we say? We both understood. Yeah. No, we both understood that it was better for both of us to go our separate ways.
Do you think that's what? I mean, it's extraordinary to think of your success when you were 12, I think, when you Zach and you were.
Yeah.
But a lot of people starting out now, would they be well advised to ditch the established men and women in suits with big shoulder pads and do it on their own if they could?
Well, you know,
sell it on the website.
Honestly, though, the internet. We're not selling it on the website as a. I mean, that's an avenue, but. Like, for instance, right now there's an acoustic EP that you have sitting there that is on the website. That's a special thing, but
the full-length album
underneath. The full-length album will be distributed everywhere. I mean, I think what it is there's an opportunity now for bands to get closer to their fans. I mean, I really do believe that, and I think it hasn't been as easy to make that happen as
it is
now.
Do you agree with that? Is that the beauty of the internet?
I think it's the next step.
So that fans, I mean, I've been on your website, and gosh, they're keen. They're swift going into the game. I mean,
but
they can talk.
What's also special about it is that they've really... When we first came out 6 years ago, it was the first album, and those fans are the same. I mean, they're
right.
The hardcore fans are here now. They're our peers. They're 22 and 18 to 24. You know, those they've really gone there with us.
But also, what you have to understand
is it's. I mean, we've been lucky enough to have a fan base that really is the first internet generation.
Yeah, so they're all very happy to. Hollywood's smallest star has unveiled Hollywood's smallest bodyguard. It's weird.